time, if you're going to get grabbed by an assailant, you're walking home on a drone or something like that, then there are certain techniques that you can actually use. If you're up against somebody or someone grabs you who's like very, very strong, you tend to use things like joint locks and chokes and stuff to be able to get yourself out of that. Because if you're good at those sort of things, it doesn't matter the size of your opponent, you can actually use that against them. So jiu-jitsu was designed for a smaller person to defeat a bigger person. That's how it was historically sort of derived. So what we're going to do, we're going to start off with, is we're going to use a rear sort of grab. So if he's stood here, and you might get someone trying to pull you, coming backwards like this, okay? So again, obviously everything that we do, you're going to do it really gently with each other. You're just going to take one arm around here, and then just pull back slowly, or just hold. All right, so Aaron does it to me. So Aaron's got his arm here. So again, this is like a rear choke hold. So the most important thing, what I should be doing is just trying to get my fingers into here and pull that away from my throat, so at least I've got some breathing, some airway to be able to survive the first part, okay? So all we're gonna do to start off with is, if he's got one arm around, I've got to establish which arm he's got here. I'm gonna put my fingers in here, I'm gonna pull that away from my neck so I can actually start breathing. If I don't, then he can actually choke me from there, okay? So literally from this position, bring the fingers in, pull away, okay? And keep your grip really, really tight. All right, we're going to start with that, and then obviously I'm going to show you some maneuvers from that position. The first safety protocol, though, is if someone grabs you, you get your hand in, and you pull their arm away from the throat. Okay, everyone all right with that? If you get yourselves into pairs, there's an odd number, you can go into three. Make sure you've got enough space. I know where Aaron's elbow is, so I know this is left arm, okay? So I'm going to get my hand in. The first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to turn to my left. So as I turn to my left, if you watch my left foot, I'm going to step behind Aaron's foot, so I start to turn here. Okay, I'll keep that pulled away, and then what I'm going to do very gently is to step forward with my right foot, and then bring him down to the back. Safety aspect of this. When we go here, I'll pull this away, I step behind this foot here. Okay, as I step forward, if we just change angle. As I step forward here, and I just use my upper body to control him downward. And I keep hold of him, because the worst thing you could do is just let go of somebody. You're going to injure each other, okay? So try and keep hold of the arm and lower each other down gently. So, the grip's there. So this is left arm, so I need to turn to this side. So I turn, I keep hold of this. Okay, and then all I'm going to do is step forward with this one and trip downward. All right, so if you do that, I'll do that at a quick pace. Wait, everybody wait, please. Okay, I'll just demonstrate it a little bit quicker, all right? So eventually, what it becomes is this. As soon as you grab the turn. Okay, so we're going to do it nice and slow. His hands around my neck, strangle position. Yeah. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grip his wrist. I'm going to pull his wrist onto my chest here. So I pull his hands again away from my airway. It's really important that you do that. Okay. So you're going to pull back here. Then I've got one leg which is closest to Aaron here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn on my side, and I'm going to bring my knee and shin across basically his belly here. So I've got a barrier now, so if he tries to push him with his hands, I can keep him away from my neck. All right, so all I do is use my leg here. Okay, so once he's in this position here, it's around my neck, he's at the side, so make sure we start in the side position. I'll use both hands. I bring my hands and I try and pull his thumbs away from my throat. Okay, I'm going to turn on my side, so I turn towards him, and then I bring my shin across his hips and belly here. All right, so if he starts to push in, I keep my leg nice and strong, so I can keep him. I've got a barrier there, so I can keep him off my leg. All right, don't do this. Pull and then turn away, because if I turn away, he goes to my back and choke me from the rear. Okay, so what I need to do is pull here, pull in, turn towards him on my hip, put my shin across. So I put my shin across the hips here, and I still control the hands. So I keep the hands away from my throat, and I use my leg as a barrier to keep him off my throat again, okay? So stop me from being strangled. So your legs are really important, because we use our legs a lot in jiu-jitsu, because obviously your legs are your strongest body part. Okay, any questions? Okay, so he comes to the side. Around the neck. I'm going to trap the hands. Okay, remember some of you have gone far side, maybe always go near side, so it's the one closest always. So I go here and I keep hold of his wrist. What I'm going to do with this leg now, I'm going to bring my leg up and I'm going to slide it over his neck here. Okay, I'm going to pinch my knees. All right, and then I'm going to drive my heel to the floor. And then what we're going to do is use an arm lock, okay? So the arm lock. I'm going to pinch my knees together. I'm going to take his arm across my hips, thumb up, and very gently, I'm going to lever down with my arms here, and then lift my hips up, so it causes pressure against the elbow joint here. So very, very slowly, I'm going to do this. Once Aaron feels the pressure on his elbow, he's just going to tap my leg, which is a signal for me to let go. All right, the last thing I want you to do is drive your hips up and then break someone's arm. Okay, so you're going to do it really, really slowly. So one more time. He's at the side here. Okay, he's in the strangle position. Trap his hands. Near side knee. Use that as a barrier to keep him off you. Keep hold of the wrists up. This leg is going to come up and around the side of the neck here. And what I do, I pinch my knees together and I very slowly drive my heel to the floor. Puts him on his back. Going to keep his thumb pointed up to the lights here. I'm just going to lean back really gently, pinch, and then drive my hips upward. As soon as you feel the pressure on your elbow, tap your partner's leg. Okay? And then they should let go. All right, do you all understand, yeah?
Yeah.
180 degrees here, okay? So I have to almost like trip him with this leg. If I just do this, it's not enough, I need to trip him as well. So as I set here, watch this trip. Okay, so you have to trip their leg. All right, when you do a full carry, you trip their leg as well, okay? All right, so let's do it. Pinch his head between my hamstring and calf, okay, and then what I'm going to do is here. Alright, so we're just going to go to that position, I'll show you what to do after, but watch again. So again, control the wrist, airways, turn in, barrier, okay, but then the other leg comes over the top, don't go underneath, it comes over the top of the arms, while I keep hold of both wrists, over the top. Pinch my knees together, and drive my heel downward. Okay, to this point. Elbow joint, you can put pressure on the elbow joint, and you would use your whole body to do that. So if you're up against somebody a lot stronger, you put your body weight against the elbow joint, you should be in a better position. Okay, so when we do this arm lock position, as soon as your arm goes straight, once it's being applied to you, and you feel a little bit of pressure on your elbow, tap your partner. Okay, and once you tap your partner, your partner should let go. All right, what I don't want you to do is put your arm lock on full and break someone's arm, okay? So you have to be really, really careful with this next technique. So Aaron's at the side here. So first thing I establish is to trap the arms, okay? Make sure I can breathe. Okay, I'm going to turn my inside knee in, so I've got my barrier. This leg comes from here, I'm going to swing it all the way over here. So I turn partially on my side, I drop my heel down to the mat. Okay, so what I'm going to do from here, I'm going to keep my knees pinched together. So I clamp down here, my foot is on the floor, the other one is just pinched here. I'm going to turn so his thumb, which is on the bottom arm, his thumb is pointing upwards, so his elbow is aligned up with my hips. Okay, and what I'm going to do is with both hands, I'm going to pull down on his arm, and I'm going to lift my hips up. So all my weight is going into his elbow joint. Okay, so if you get attacked, you can attack the joint, damage somebody's arm, and get yourself away to safety. Okay, so you have to do this really slowly, girl. So he's in my neck here. Trap, turn in, bring the leg over. Pitch my knees together really tight. Sit as close to him as possible. So I need to get his elbow joint, okay, which is the bottom arm. Okay, so I put two arms on his wrist here. I'm going to drive his arm down and then slowly move my hips up. Once he feels the pressure on his arm, he taps me and I let go instantly. Okay, so please do that last part really slowly. Once I go here, I'm going to start to turn this way. As I turn, I'm going to step with my left foot, and I'm going to trap his arm underneath my foot. Okay, so I can control the elbow. Okay, so I've got a lock on the elbow joint and the shoulder. So if you notice, when I do this position, I'm up and he's down, so I'm in full control. What you don't want to do is this, and go down with them, because they might end up coming onto the floor. Okay, so he grabs here, or you can grab my t-shirt. All right, I've got two hands, fingers on top. Okay, as I turn so his elbows pointed upwards, okay? And I'm going to step at the same time, so I step in front of him here. So you get this motion here, and I control the elbow. Okay, so make sure this is clamped in. All right, the pressure you should find is a lot on the shoulder and a little bit on the elbow. Okay, because the more pressure I get here, his head's going to go down, so I've got more control of him here. If I go up here, then he can stand up and hit me or something. Okay, so go again. Grip. Two hands. So I establish the elbow, turn the elbow up, and step around. So I step in front here. My arm goes over the top.